The kingdom has never conducted itself in this way. It has been always moderate, very low-key, and has always been accommodative. And now suddenly you find these extraordinary developments that are taking place, and we hear about beatings and kidnappings and people being incarcerated and tortured. This is quite horrendous, and it is quite without precedent in recent times. The kingdom that we knew till about 2 years ago, to my mind, no longer exists. It is a completely transformed scenario. We have never had a situation where so much power is enjoyed by one young prince, political, economic, and military power and decision making. We have never seen so much aggressiveness against its own citizens. There has been a certain connectivity in this regard with the United States. And I think that is the source of strength and authority as far as His Highness the Crown Prince is concerned. But this has not been used to the extent that it should have been, in the ways that it should have been. There was a promise of reform. There was a promise of legitimate change. And that was welcomed by many of us. What we have seen instead is extraordinary repression of the kind we have not seen before. You know, all matters pertaining to the royal family are extremely opaque, and any kind of speculation is not particularly useful or even helpful. Having said this, we have noticed, for instance, that His Majesty had intervened in regard to the IPO, the Aramco IPO, and had reversed a pet project of the Crown Prince. So, yes, we could think it through. We do not know what is actually happening. All we have heard is that His Majesty has sent, he had sent Prince Khalid Al Faisal to Turkey to explain the Saudi perspective with regard to this horrendous event. But what we are seeing in the Saudi media now is a deliberate tarnishing of the reputation of Adnan Khashoggi. That is something which is quite unacceptable. They are even suggesting that he is sympathetic to Al-Qaeda and to the Islamic State, which is completely wrong. And that is what is bothering me very much. This kind of tarnishing of this man, who I think was one of the most outstanding journalists in the kingdom.